There we go. Thank you. All right. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, Thomas Clark will be coming out, and here he is. Let me just say a few words here. Thomas Clark's focus is to bring communities together throughout country and beyond through live performance, collaborative art, and workshops, to take art beyond the museums and galleries and into the public square so one feels and sees the experience in the process. His goal is to make art accessible. And in a faith environment, it's a collaboration of the spirit and an act of worship. And we have Danny Ibarra. He's going to be playing along with him. Enjoy.
Do it, baby. Go ahead. Hi, everybody. So this is not normal to talk while I'm painting because I got to put two brains. I got to get the left brain and the right brain connected, but I'm going to give it a shot here. So a lot of time when I'm painting, I've got to prepare mentally, physically. I'm combining the right brain. I'm combining the logic. I'm combining the compassion of the right brain. And I'm trying to make a painting regarding that. Sometimes it's coming up with sketches and ideas before. And by the way, Danny Ibarra, baby. Hey! So, what we're going to talk about tonight is I had a dream. Didn't know about a week ago what I was going to be painting. Dream music. So I couldn't get to sleep one night. I was thinking, why can't I get to sleep? I went to sleep. I had this dream. And it was like, have you ever been in a parking structure and there's this circular kind of thing going down, concrete, as you go down to each step? Well, as we start moving down the structure, people are killing each other off. I know this sounds a little PG-13. And I couldn't understand what was going on. And it was kind of this conical shape going down, almost like a drain. And all the people across from me were like an opposition, an enemy. And as we get closer, you start realizing this isn't going to end well. People are getting closer and we're killing each other off. But then I started seeing the people and their faces became more human and more beautiful. And I was kind of seeing them closer, kind of as God sees us, face to face, close. They weren't really an opponent, per se. There was no weapons that I could perceive. But as I noticed, we got eye contact, they became more beautiful, and I understand and had compassion for them. And everybody realized at that point, the only thing was to give in, to submit. And then what we start realizing is there was a sense of trying to control the situation. And basically, we have the logic of the mind, the head. Technically, the heart and the head come from the brain, but for use of analogy here, I'm going to use a hand as the representing the heart. And so basically, we've got logic of the mind, seeking truth, taking things and trying to get them into a functional structure, right? And then we have the judgmental, right or wrong. It can manifest itself without the heart. It manifests itself in right and wrong. And then we have the heart on this side, which is more organic, feeling, discovering authenticity. And without that head, it can become righteous, injustice, oppressor versus oppressor. righteousness, victimhood, and fear. So what do we do with that? We open our hands to each other. We surrender. Not to our opponents or who we perceive as opponents, but we surrender to the greatest authority, the Almighty God. Because that's the only thing that is truth and beauty. God created us all unique, different, diverse culture, colors, history. And if we aren't connected to our God, our counselor, our creator, we're kind of like a mosh pit with punk rock music, and we're bouncing off the walls. We don't have anyone to dance with. We are in our own head. But when we're with God and listening to His Spirit, we're kind of in this beautiful waltz. We're dancing together. Or we're maybe even doing a little samba. Danny, do you got a samba? Yeah. So we're moving. We're grooving with God. To use an example, we've got the structured music of classical music. You got some classical, Danny? So the classical music rests our soul. It goes to our synaptic nerves, it gives us rest. It allows us to hear God's word. And it unleashes our heart in our minds. And in our heart. What I love about this evening is we're connecting the apologists. Apologists take all the information from the macro to the micro to find truth. The artists take the micro to the macro to find authenticity and to reveal, like we're doing right here. But we need both. We need to combine, expose and uncover our minds to truth, what leads to wisdom, which then opens our hearts to compassion. And neither work without the other. Let your heart, with God's grace, be measured with your head through God's word, which becomes wisdom and leads you to God's truth. Be quick to listen. And slow to speak. You guys ready?
I've tried so hard to see it. Took me so long to believe it. someone like me to carry your victory. Perfection could never earn it. You give what we don't deserve, and you take the broken things and raise them to glory. To receive it, so let all the striving cease. Oh, this is my victory. You are my champion. Giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle. With the one who has conquered it all. When I open up my mouth, every wall comes crashing down. I have the authority Jesus has given me. Thank you. his hands, where his plans are greater than mine. So here I stand wide awake with my hands to the sky. My God opened up my eyes and he put this spark in me. My God is the creator, holds my eternity in his hands, where his plans are greater than mine. So
I know it's late, so just a couple quick announcements. As Tom finishes the painting, you can stay and hang out for that as well. Dr. Scott will be in the back in the hallway with some of his items, which we'll also talk about on Sunday. If you could just do me a favor, stop by and take a look at it, but make room if people want to talk to him. He is on East Coast time. He flew in from Michigan, so I know it's late for him right now. It's about midnight, so if you have like a really deep theological question, he will be gracious to sit there with you until he falls asleep at the table at 3 a.m. But let's not make him do that. So touch base, see what he's got. Don't forget, he'll be here on Sunday as well, hanging out during the day. Tomorrow morning, the doors open at 8:30. We do have donuts for you, as well as a yogurt parfait bar and free coffee in the cafe. That's black coffee, but the cafe will also be selling all the ridiculous stuff you put in your coffee drinks as well. But please arrive at 8:30 tomorrow. We'll have those things for you again. Lunch will be here provided for our lunch break, and our plan is to close by 3 p.m. tomorrow. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that your word is trustworthy, and as people discover and find more and more copies of it, it continues to prove that it is true. We thank you, Father, that we can be gentle apologists dealing with skeptical questions and asking questions and creating conversations that the world desperately needs. And Lord, we do it all by merging our heads and our hearts. That's what this is about. It's not just about learning all the intellect or just only feeling, but seeing those things come together. So ultimately, Father, we can be the people of your word. We are the apologetic to those around us. And let us be that as we learn those things about you and express those things through art. We just thank you for being with us this evening. Please bless everyone as they drive home this evening, that they be safe. Give them deep, deep rest tonight, that they'd wake up fired up to come back tomorrow to hear more from the people that you've brought to us to share with us tomorrow. We thank you, Lord. In your name we pray, amen. All right, see you tomorrow at 8:30.